midnight mass. The Holy Father carries the pastoral staff, the crozier. He wears the mitre and the ring, all of which are symbols of his office as the Bishop of Rome. And over his chasuble, he wears the vestment called the pallium, which is the sign that he is a metropolitan bishop. He is the metropolitan of the province of Rome. There is Cardinal Sodano, the papal secretary of state. That was Archbishop Cacevillan kissing the altar. He used to be nuncio in the United States, and he was followed by Cardinal Ruini, the Pope's vicar there, Cardinal Sciocca on the right. He is the president of the Commission for Vatican City State. This is the altar as a sign of reverence. That book is a reproduction of the special pontifical book for Christmas, which had been commissioned by Pope Alexander VI, who was Pope from 1492 to 1507. And it is in the stand that was used to hold the scriptures for the First and Second Vatican Councils. The Holy Father incenses the altar as a sign of reverence. The altar represents Jesus. And just as the Holy Father kissed the altar in reverence, he incenses it. There used to be a prayer, "Let my incense ascend as a sweet fragrance." It represents our prayer ascending to God. The Sistine Choir is saying, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you."
Domine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Pax vobis.
Peace be with you.
Fratelli e sorelle carissimi, grande è il mistero della pietà che celebriamo nella gioia in questa santissima notte.
Great is the mystery of the holy truth which we celebrate in joy in this most holy night. The long wait of the peoples has found its accomplishment in the fullness of time. The only begotten Son of the Father has become one of us through the work of the Holy Spirit, and he has been born of the Virgin Mary. In the night of humanity, there breaks forth the new light, a light without dust, a light of truth, which puts to flight darkness and causes peace to arrive. The fire buried under the ashes is revived, and the mind and heart sing as they recognize the events which give renewed hope to us who are pilgrims in the diverse stages of life. And now you will have the chanting of the calends, the part that used to be called the martyrology. There were read the saints of the day, those who had died for the faith. And in this case, there is read the story of the birth of Jesus.
Octavo calendas januari, luna vigesima quarta. In numeris transactis
the octave of the calends of January, the 24th moon,
that's
the equivalent of December 25th.
Quando in principio Deus creavi celum et terra,
many centuries having passed from when God had created the world and had made man in his own image. And many centuries after the flood had ended, and the Most High had displayed the rainbow, the sign of covenant and peace.
Amigrazione Abrahe, patris nostri infide, de Ur Caldeorum,
seculo vigesimo primo.
Ab egressu populi Israel de Egypto, Moise duce.
13 centuries after the exodus of Israel from Egypt, under the guidance of Moses.
Ab unctione David in regem, anno circiter millesimo.
Approximately 1,000 years after the anointing of David as king of Israel.
Quinta, iuxta Danielis profetia,
in the 65th Olympia week according to the prophecy of Daniel.
Nonagesima quarta. Ab urbe condita,
about the time of the 194th Olympiad, in the year 752 of the foundation of Rome, in the 42nd year of the empire of Octavius Augustus,
quadragesimo secundo, tot orbe in pace composito.
While peace reigned in the land,
Jesus Christus eternus Deus, eternique Patris Filius,
Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the Eternal Father, desiring to sanctify the world with his coming. 9 months having passed from the time of his conception by the power of the Holy Spirit,
in Bethlehem Juden nascitus,
is born in Bethlehem of Judea,
Maria Virgine,
of the Virgin Mary,
factus homo,
and became man.
Nativitas Domini nostri Jesu Christi, secundum carnem.
The birth of our Lord Jesus Christ according to the flesh, that is, in his human nature.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Glory to God in the highest. Peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. These 12 children from around the world have been chosen to bring floral offerings to the Christ child. They come from India, Germany, Italy, the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Mexico, the Philippines, and Korea. Girl from Korea. Her name is Kiara Jeong. The girl from the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Steffi Mboy. Together with Thierry Bolico. Mexican in his characteristic suit. To the land from the Nuncio in the United States, Cardinal Rolini, the Pope's vicar for Rome. Cardinal Stafford, the former Archbishop of Denver. Cardinal Shoka, the former Archbishop of Detroit, now in charge of Vatican City State.
Oremus. Deus, viam sacratissimam noctem, vir illuminis fecisti illustratione clarescere.
Father, you made this holy night radiant with the splendor of Jesus Christ, our light. We welcome him as Lord, the true light of the world. Bring us to eternal joy in the kingdom of heaven, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. By the way, the Sistine Choir is led by Monsignor Giuseppe Liberto, is made up of an adult section and a section of boys. And the organist for St. Peter's Basilica is J. Edward Getchi from California, who was also in Omaha.
The El pueblo que caminaba en tinieblas dio una luz grande.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian.
Ha nacido. Un hijo se nos ha dado.
For every boot that tramped in battle, lleva every cloak rolled in blood,
el principado,
will be burned as fuel for flame.
Y es su nombre, maravilla de consejero.
For a child
Guerrero.
Is born to us, a son is given us.
Padre
upon his shoulder
perpetuo.
Dominion rests. They name him Wonder
Príncipe
Counselor, God Hero,
de la Paz.
Father Forever, Prince of Peace.
Para dilatar el principado
his dominion
con una
is
paz
vast and forever
sin
peaceful.
Limites.
From David's
sobre
throne
el trono
and over his
de
kingdom,
David,
which he confirms
y sobre
and sustains.
Su reino. Para
my judgment
sostenerlo
justice, both
y consolidarlo con la justicia y el derecho, desde ahora y por siempre. El celo del Señor lo realizará.
The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The reader was Alessandra, or rather the reader was Alejandra Correa, from Santiago, Chile originally, but she now lives in Miami, Florida. The psalm will be sung by Adriano Caroletti.
Oggi è nato per noi il Salvatore.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Cantate al Signore un canto nuovo. Cantate al Signore da tutta la terra. Cantate al Signore, benedite il suo nome.
Today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
Annunziate di giorno in giorno la la sua salvezza.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds.
A tutte le nazioni dite i suoi prodigi.
Oggi per la nostra gloria, il Salvatore.
Gioiscano i cieli, esulti la terra.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice.
Frema il mare quanto racchiude.
Let the sea and what fills it resound.
Esultino i campi e quanto contengono.
Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them.
Si rallegrino gli alberi della foresta.
Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
Esultino davanti al Signore che viene.
They shall exult before the Lord, for he comes.
Perché viene a giudicare la terra.
For he comes to rule the earth.
Giudicherà il mondo con giustizia.
He shall rule the world with justice.
Con verità tutte le genti.
The peoples with his constancy. The people sing, today is born our Savior, Christ the Lord.
A reading from the letter of Paul to Titus. The grace of God has appeared, offering salvation to all men. It trains us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of the great God and of our Savior, Christ Jesus. It was he who sacrificed himself for us to redeem us from all unrighteousness and to cleanse for himself a people of his own, eager to do what is right.
Verbum Domini.
The reading was done by Robert Lampett, a second-year student at the North American College from the Diocese of Peoria, Illinois. You will see two tapestries tonight. That's the tapestry of the Nativity, the other is a tapestry of the Annunciation, when the angel Gabriel announced to Mary that she was to be the Mother of God. There, of course, you have one of the Swiss guards in their very formal attire with their hats with the red plumes. The Holy Father is putting incense into the censer thurible. The servers tonight are members of the Legionaries of Christ, and among those from the English-speaking world are Anthony Sortino of Phoenix, Arizona, who is carrying the Pope's mitre, Benjamin Sieple of, who is carrying the Pope's crozier, he's from Columbus, Ohio, Mark Fallon, who is from Ann Arbor, Michigan, who is carrying one of the candles, Viet Tran, a seminarian of Vietnamese background from San Antonio, who has the towel for the washing of the Pope's hands, and Simon Devera from Dunedin, New Zealand, who is carrying the little boat with incense that is imposed in the therapy. The people have just sung Alleluia. I proclaim to you good news of great joy. Today a Savior is born for us, Christ the Lord. Alleluia. The gospel will be sung by Mariano Diotto.
Dominus vobiscum.
The Lord be with you.
Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Factum est in diebus illis. Exit edictum a Caesare Augusto, ut describeretur universus orbi.
In those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world would be enrolled. This was the first enrollment, when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town.
Ascendit autem et Joseph a Galilea de Civitate Nazareth.
And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child.
Factum est autem cum essent tibi.
While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son.
Et pannis eum involvit, et reclinavit eum in presepio.
She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Et pastores erant in regione Adem, vigilantes et custodientes vigilia noctis supra.
Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock.
Et ecce angelus Domini stetit iusta illos.
The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them.
Et timuerum timore magnum.
And they were struck with great fear.
Et dixit illis angelus.
The angel said to them,
Nolite timere.
Do not be afraid.
Ecce enim evangelizo vobis.
For behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy.
Quod erit omni
populo. That will be for all the people.
Quia natus est vobis odie salvator.
For today in the city of David,
Christus Dominus,
a Savior has been born for you,
Civitate Dei,
who is Christ the Lord.
Et hoc vobis signum.
And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
Et subito facta est cum angelo multitudo militiae celestis.
And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying,
Gloria in altissimis Deo, et super terram pax, in hominibus bone voluntatis.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those of good will. The Gospel of the Lord. As you heard, the Gospel was chanted in Latin. The first reading was done in Spanish, the responsorial psalm in Italian, and the second reading was done in English. Choir sang, To you our praise, to you our song, to you glory, God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. And now the Holy Father is preparing to give his first homily for Christmas Day as Pope.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
Dear brothers and sisters,
il Signore mi ha detto, tu sei mio figlio, io oggi ti ho generato.
The Lord said to me, you are my son.
Con queste parole del Salmo secondo, la Chiesa inizia la Santa Messa della Veglia di Natale, nella quale celebriamo la nascita del nostro Redentore, Gesù Cristo nella stalla di Betlemme.
The birth of Jesus Christ our Redeemer
Una
in a stable
volta,
in Bethlehem.
Questo salmo apparteneva al rituale dell'incoronazione dei re di Giuda.
This psalm was once
Il
a part of the coronation rite of the kings of Judah.
Della sua elezione,
the people of Israel,
si in, modo
in virtue of its choice, its election,
di Dio,
considered itself in a special way a son of God, adopted by God.
Siccome il re era la personificazione di quel popolo,
just as the re, as the king was the personification of the people,
era vissuta come un atto solenne di adozione da parte di Dio,
as a solemn act
nel quale
of adoption
re veniva
by God.
In qualche modo coinvolto nel mistero
whereby the
Dio.
King was in some way taken up into the very
Della
mystery
di
of
Betlemme,
God. At Bethlehem night, these words,
che erano di fatto più
which were really more an expression of hope
che una realtà presente,
than a present reality,
hanno assunto un senso nuovo
took
ed
on
inaspettato.
New and unexpected meaning.
Il bimbo nel presepe è davvero Il figlio di Dio.
The child lying in the manger
Dio
is truly God's son.
Perenne,
God is not
ma
eternal
un certo
solitude,
d'amore
but rather a circle of love and mutual self-giving. He is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Ancora di più, in Gesù Cristo, il Figlio di Dio, Dio stesso.
But there is more.
Dio da Dio,
in Jesus Christ, the Son of God, God Himself
became man. A lui il Padre
dice
realmente tu sei il mio figlio.
To Him the Father says, "You are my Son."
L'eterno occhi di Dio.
God's everlasting today has come down into the fleeting today of the world. And has lifted our momentary today into God's eternal today. God is so great that He can become small. God is so powerful that He can make Himself vulnerable and come to us as a defenseless child
noi possiamo amarlo.
So that we can love Him.
Dio è così buono da rinunciare al suo splendore
God is
divino
so good that He can give up His divine splendor and come down to His stable
affinché noi possiamo trovarlo.
So that we might find Him.
E perché così la sua bontà tocchi
so that His goodness
noi.
Might touch us.
Si comunichi a noi,
give itself to us,
continua ad operare
and
per
continue
nostro
to work through us.
Questo è Natale. Tu sei mio figlio.
This is Christmas. You are my son. This day I have begotten you.
Dio diventato uno di noi,
God has become one of
affinché
us,
noi potessimo essere
so that we
con
can
lui,
be with Him and become
diventare
like Him.
Simili a Lui. Ha scelto come suo segno,
as a sign,
il bimbo
He chose the child lying in
Egli
the manger.
È così.
This is
in
how God
questo
is.
Modo, impariamo a conoscerlo.
This is how we come to know Him.
E su ogni bambino rifulge qualcosa
and on every child shines something of the splendor of that today,
di Dio,
of that closeness
amare,
of God,
ed alla quale dobbiamo
which we ought to love
su ogni bambino,
and to which we must yield.
Anche su quello non ancora nato.
It shines on every child, even those still unborn.
La seconda parola della liturgia di questa notte santa.
Let us listen to a second
questa
phrase from the liturgy of this holy night,
dal libro del
one taken from the
Isaiah,
book of the prophet Isaiah.
Su coloro che abitavano in terra tenebrosa,
upon the people who walked in darkness, a great light has shone.
La parola luce,
the word light,
pervade tutta la liturgia di
pervades
Santa
the
Messa,
entire liturgy of tonight's Mass.
È accennata nuovamente nel brano tratto dalla lettera di San Paolo a
Tito. It is found again in the passage drawn from St. Paul's letter to Titus.
L'espressione è apparsa. Appartiene al linguaggio greco.
The grace of God has appeared. The expression has appeared in the original Greek says the same thing that was expressed in Hebrew
una luce
by the words a light has shone.
L'apparizione, l'epifania,
this apparition, this epiphany
l'irruzione
is the breaking
della luce
of God's
divina
light
nel mondo pieno
upon
di buio,
a world full of darkness
e pieno di
and unsolved problems.
Irrisolti. Infine, il Vangelo ci racconta che ai pastori
finally, the Gospel relates that the glory of the
Dio,
Lord
Eli avvolse di luce,
appeared to the shepherds
dove compare
and shone
la gloria
around them.
Di Dio, là si diffonde nel mondo
wherever God's glory appears, light spreads
e
throughout the world.
Non ci sono tenebre, dice San Giacomo. La luce è fonte.
Saint John tells us
di vita.
That God is light, and in
ma
Him there is no darkness.
Soprattutto
the light
conoscenza.
Is a source of life.
Significa verità, in contrasto col buio della menzogna e dell'ignoranza.
But first, light means knowledge, it
così
means truth,
la luce ci
as contrasted
vivere,
with the darkness of falsehood and ignorance.
La strada.
Light gives us life, it shows us the way.
La luce in quanto dona calore,
but light, as a source of heat,
amore.
Also means love.
Dove c'è amore emerge una luce nel mondo.
Where there is love,
dove c'è odio,
light shines forth in the world.
Nel buio.
Where there is hatred, the world
nella
remains
stalla di
in darkness.
È apparsa la grande luce.
In the stable of Bethlehem
attende.
There appeared the great light which the world awaits.
Bimbo c'accente nella stalla,
and that child lying
Dio
in the stable,
mostra la sua gloria.
God has shown his glory.
La gloria della verità,
the glory of love,
la gloria dell'amore,
which gives itself away,
se stesso,
stripping itself of all grandeur.
Per condurci anche noi
in order to guide us along the way of love.
La luce di Betlemme non si è mai spenta.
The light of Bethlehem has never been extinguished.
Ha toccato uomini e donne, li ha avvolti di luce.
In every age it has touched men and women.
Dove è spuntata la fede in quel bambino,
it has shone around them.
Gli è sbocciata anche la carità.
Wherever people put their faith in that child, charity also sprang up. Charity toward others, loving concern for the weak and the suffering, the grace of forgiveness. From Bethlehem has come a stream of light, love, and truth, which spreads through the centuries.
Da Paolo ed Agostino,
if we look to the saints, from Paul and Augustine
Domenico,
to Francis and Dominic,
da Francesco Saverio,
from
Teresa
Francis
d'Avila,
Xavier and Teresa of Avila,
Madre Teresa di Calcutta,
to Mother Teresa of Calcutta,
vediamo questa corrente di bontà, questa via
we
di
see
luce,
this flood of goodness, this path of light, kindled ever anew by the mystery of Bethlehem.
A quel Dio che si è fatto bambino.
By that God who became a child.
Contro la violenza di questo mondo,
in that child,
Dio oppone
God
in quel bambino
countered
la
the
sua
violence
bontà,
of this world with
e
his
ci
own
chiama
goodness.
A seguire il bambino.
He calls us to follow that child.
Insieme con Albero di Natale, I nostri amici austriaci
along with the Christmas tree, our Austrian friends have also brought us a small flame lit in Bethlehem.
Che avevano acceso a Betlemme per dirci il vero mistero del
as if to say that the true mystery of Christmas is the inner brightness radiating from this child.
Da questo bambino. Lasciamo che tale splendore interiore si comunichi.
May that inner brightness spread to us.
Che accenda
and enkindle in our hearts
la fiammella
the
della
flame
bontà
of
di
God's
Dio.
Goodness.
Portiamo tutti col nostro amore luce.
May all of us by our love bring light to the world.
Non permettiamo che questa fiamma luminosa accesa
let us keep
nella
this light-giving flame from being extinguished by the cold winds of our time.
Del nostro tempo. Custodiamola fedelmente e facciamone dono
let
agli altri.
Guard it faithfully and give it to others.
In questa notte nella quale guardiamo verso Betlemme
on this night when we look toward
vogliamo
Bethlehem
anche pregare.
Let us pray in a special way
per il luogo della nascita
for the birthplace of our
Redeemer e per gli uomini che la vivono
and for
e
the
soffrono.
Men and women who live and suffer
vogliamo
there.
Pregare per la pace in terra santa.
We wish to pray for
guarda,
peace in
Signore,
the Holy Land.
Quest'angolo della terra,
look, O Lord, upon this corner of the earth,
tanto caro,
your homeland, which was so very dear to you.
La tua luce fa che gli arrivi la pace.
Let your light shine upon it. Let it know
con
peace.
Il termine pace, siamo giunti alla terza parola guida della liturgia di questa notte santa.
The word peace brings us to the third key
Isaia annuncia,
to the liturgy of this holy night.
Chiamato principe della pace.
The child foretold by Isaiah is called Prince of Peace.
Dice, la pace non avrà fine.
His kingdom is said to be one of
ai
endless
pastori
peace.
Si annuncia nel Vangelo la gloria di Dio nel più alto dei cieli
the shepherds
e
in the gospel hear the glad tidings
in terra.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace.
Si diceva agli uomini di buona volontà.
At one time we used to say to men of goodwill.
La nuova tradizione si dice.
Nowadays we say
agli uomini che egli ama.
To those whom God loves.
Che significa questo cambiamento?
What does this change mean?
Non conta più la buona volontà?
Is goodwill no longer important?
Poniamo meglio la domanda.
We would do better to ask.
Quali sono gli uomini che Dio ama? E perché
who are those
ama?
Whom God loves, and why does he love them?
Dio è forse parziale?
Does God have favorites?
Ama forse soltanto alcuni?
Does he love only certain people while abandoning the others to themselves?
Il Vangelo risponde a queste domande.
The gospel answers these questions
alcune precise persone amate
by pointing
da Dio.
To some particular people
ci sono
whom God
persone
loves.
Singole, Maria,
there are individuals like Mary,
Giuseppe,
Joseph,
Elizabeth, Zaccaria,
Zachariah,
Simeone, Anna,
Simeon, Anna.
Ma ci sono anche due gruppi di persone.
But there are also two persone, groups of people.
I pastori,
the shepherds,
I sapienti dell'Oriente,
and the wise men
remaci.
From the east, the magi.
Soffermiamoci in questa notte sui pastori.
Tonight let's look at the shepherds.
Che specie di uomini sono? Nel loro
what
ambiente,
kind of people were
i pastori
they?
Erano disprezzati.
In the world of their time, shepherds were looked down upon. They were considered untrustworthy, and they weren't admitted as witnesses in court.
Ma chi erano in realtà?
But really, who were they?
Certamente non erano grandi santi,
to be sure, they weren't great saints.
Si intendono persone di virtù eroiche.
If by that word we mean
erano
people of heroic virtue,
semplici.
They were simple souls.
Il Vangelo mette in luce
the gospel sheds light on one feature
che poi nelle parole di Gesù
which later on in the words of
avrà
Jesus
un ruolo importante.
Would take on particular importance.
Erano persone vigilanti.
They were people who were watchful.
Prima nel senso esteriore.
This was chiefly true in a superficial way.
Vicino alle loro pecore.
They kept watch over their flocks
vale
by night.
Anche in un senso più profondo.
But it was also true
erano
in a deeper way.
Disponibili per la parola di Dio.
They were ready to
per
receive God's word.
Dell'angelo.
Their life was not
la loro
closed
vita
in on
non
itself.
Era chiusa in se stessa.
Their hearts were open.
Il loro cuore era aperto. In qualche modo nel più profondo erano in attesa.
In some way deep down they were waiting
in attesa
for him.
Finalmente di Dio.
Their watchfulness
la loro vigilanza era
was a kind of
disponibilità.
Readiness.
Disponibilità ad ascoltare.
A readiness to listen.
Disponibilità ad incamminarsi.
A readiness to set out.
Era attesa della luce che indicasse
they were waiting
loro
for a
via.
Light. Which would show them the way.
Che a Dio interessa.
This is what is important
Dio ama
for God.
Tutti, perché tutti
God
sono
loves
creature
everyone
sue.
Because everyone
ma
is his creature.
Alcune persone hanno chiuso la loro anima.
But some persons have
il
closed their hearts.
Non trova presso di loro
there is no door
nessun
by which his
accesso.
Love can enter.
Essi credono di non aver bisogno di Dio. Non
they
lo
think
vogliono.
They do not need God. Nor do they want him.
Che forse moralmente sono
other
ugualmente
persons,
miseri e peccatori,
who from a moral standpoint are perhaps no less wretched and sinful,
essi attendono di Dio,
at least
attendono
experience
Dio.
A certain remorse.
Sanno di aver bisogno della sua bontà.
They are waiting for
anche
God.
Anche se non hanno un'idea precisa.
They realize that they need his goodness,
nel
even if they don't have a clear idea of what this means.
La luce di Dio può entrare e con essa la sua pace.
Into their expectant hearts,
Dio
God's light can enter.
Dio cerca persone
and with it his
che
peace.
Sono in questo senso nell'attesa.
God seeks
Dio
persons
cerca persone che portino
who can be vessels and heralds
e comunicano
of his peace.
La sua pace.
Let us pray.
Chiediamoli
that he will not
di far
find
sì
our hearts
che non trovi chiuso il nostro cuore. Facciamo in modo di essere in grado
let us strive to be
di diventare portatori attivi della sua pace proprio
today.
Nel nostro tempo. Tra i cristiani la parola pace ha poi assunto un significato tutto speciale.
Among Christians, the word peace has taken on a very particular meaning.
La comunione nell'Eucaristia.
It has become a name for communion in the Eucharist.
È presente la pace di Cristo.
In the Eucharist,
attraverso
Christ's
tutti
peace
i luoghi
is present.
Dove si celebra l'Eucaristia,
in all the places where the Eucharist
una
is
rete
celebrated,
di pace
a great network
sul
of peace spreads
intero.
Through the world.
Le comunità raccolte intorno all'Eucaristia
the communities gathered around the Eucharist
un regno della pace
make up a kingdom of peace as wide as the world itself.
Quando celebriamo l'Eucaristia,
when we celebrate the Eucharist,
ci troviamo a Betlemme,
we find ourselves
nella
in Bethlehem,
casa del pane.
In the house of
Cristo
bread,
si dona
the meaning
a noi
of the name Bethlehem.
E ci dona con ciò
Christ gives himself
pace.
To us, and in doing so,
ce la dona
gives
perché
us his
noi
peace.
Portiamo la luce della pace
he gives it to
nel
us
nostro intimo
so that we can carry the light of peace
e la comunichiamo agli altri.
And give it to others.
Perché diventiamo operatori di pace.
He gives it to us so we can become peacemakers and builders of peace in the world.
Alla pace nel mondo.
And so we
perciò
pray.
Preghiamo. Signore, compi la tua promessa. Fa che là dove c'è discordia
so we pray, Lord,
nasca
fulfill
la
your
pace.
Promise. Where there is conflict,
che emerga
give
l'amore
birth to
là
peace.
Dove regna l'odio.
Where there is hatred, make
fa
love
che sorga la luce
out.
Là dove dominano le
where
tenebre.
Darkness prevails, let
facci
light shine.
Diventare portatori della tua pace. Amen.
Make us heralds of your peace. Amen. The Holy Father has just completed a beautiful meditation on the meaning of Christmas. Particularly, he reflected on the role of the shepherds, those who were watchful, but which also means those who were in readiness. Readiness to accept the word of God. And the Holy Father, also commented on the importance of peace. To be peacemakers, to accept the peace of Christ. And now the Holy Father will lead the people in the recitation of the Creed.
Credo in unum Deum.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father, through him all things were made. Salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. As you note on this Christmas night, the Pope kneels at these words. March 25th and on December 25th. March 25th, the Feast of the Annunciation, when Jesus was conceived in the womb of the Mother, the Blessed Mother Mary, and on December 25th, the faithful kneel in honor of the Incarnation. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Brothers and sisters,
with recognition and renewed wonder, we have heard the announcement of the prophet. The child born for us is the Prince of Peace, the Savior, Christ the Lord. Like the shepherds, we contemplate him with Mary, his mother, and Joseph of the house of David. Through him, wonderful counselor, we lift up our prayer to the Almighty, as if to unite ourselves to the song of the heavenly host.
Dominum oremus.
We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. First will be in French by Carol Grabia of Grenoble, France.
La grâce de Dieu s'est manifestée pour le salut de tous les hommes.
God's grace has been revealed to save the whole human race.
D'Orient et d'Occident,
for the faithful of the churches of East and West, and for their pastors,
la lumière du Christ, et que
that they might shine with the light of Christ, and in awaiting the blessed hope, may find strength and courage in the grace of God, which today appears in our land. The second intention will be presented by Tobias Wahlbrecker of Munich, Germany. There's a story about him which we'll tell later.
Und auf Erden ist Friede bei den Menschen seiner Gnade.
Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to those whom he loves. For those responsible for nations and international organizations, and for workers for peace, that the truth of Christ, our peace, might enlighten them to follow closely the path of peaceful coexistence among peoples in justice and in respect for different cultures. You had just seen previously members of the diplomatic corps at this Christmas midnight mass. The ambassadors to the Holy See are expected to come.
Watu wale walio kwenda katika giza.
In Swahili, Salvatore Macha reads, the people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. For all those who recognize Abraham as their father in the faith, that illuminated by the light of God the Most High, they may give witness to him in our time with mutual respect and with works of justice and peace. Salvatore Macha, who read the prayer in Swahili, is from Moshi in Tanzania.
Sanggol sa piling natin, isang anak imnigay sa atin para sa mga musmos at mga kabataan, naway lumaki silang magalang at mapagmahal sa lahat ng mga atikain. Matuto silang dumamay at magtanggol sa mga walang malay at mga walang kumakalinga. Naway ang espiritu ng Pasko ay magsilbing tanglaw sa mga magulang at kapwa na may paggalang sa bawat nilalang.
Julie Payon of Manila has prayed, a child is born to us, a son is given to us, for children and adolescents, that there may develop always more in the consciences of all respect and care for the defenseless little ones and for weak and fragile young people.
Mroków światło zabłysło. Za poszukujących prawdy i za tych, którym trudno wyznawać jedynego i prawdziwego Boga. Niech światło Chrystusa, nowego człowieka, oświeca ich drogi. Umocnieni obecnością autentycznych świadków światłości, niech dotrą do źródła.
Gundek of Nowy Sącz, Poland, prays, let the heaven on the inhabitants of a country in shadow and dark as death, light has blazed forth. For those who search for truth and those who work to proclaim the one true God, that the light of Christ, the new man, might illuminate their path and strengthened by the presence of authentic witnesses, might arrive at the font and source of truth for which they search.
Pela nossa Assembleia e quantos estão unidos conosco através da rádio e da televisão. Que a alegria do Natal dê alívio a quem sofre, mitigue o peso da solidão de quem vive só ou abandonado.
Abelardo de Freitas prays, let the heavens rejoice and the earth exult, exult before the Lord who comes. For our assembly and all those joined through radio and television, that the joy of Christmas might bring relief to those who suffer, might lighten the weight of solitude for those who are alone or abandoned, refresh the hearts of those who are discouraged, and increase the commitment of all to live soberly, justly, and piously in this world.
Signore Padre Santo, Dio dei nostri padri, per amore ci doni nel tuo unigenito salvezza e redenzione.
O Lord, Holy Father, God of our fathers, through love you give us in your only begotten Son salvation and redemption. Hear the prayers of this family which invokes you in communion with Holy Mary, the mother of your Son, Jesus, and our mother, and with Saint Joseph, the just man, multiply the joy of your people and of all peoples, that they might recognize the light and peace of this most holy night, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I told you that there was an interesting story about Tobias Vollbrecker. Oh, by the way, here come the 12 children once again, the same ones who brought the flowers to the baby Jesus during the singing of the Gloria. This time they're bringing the sacred vessels. The story about Tobias Vollbrecker is that he and his wife every year would host in their home, they live in Rome, Cardinal Ratzinger during the time of Carnival in Munich. And last February, when the Cardinal visited their home, their two sons were dressed as Swiss guards, and the Cardinal Ratzinger said, "Oh," he said, "don't you look nice? Next year, the Pope will have to come to visit you." So it will be very interesting to see if Cardinal Ratzinger, now Pope Benedict XVI, goes back to visit the two little boys who dressed as Swiss guards. Young ladies, one from Korea and one from India, seem very happy. And two children from Mexico, Emilia Lazzazara and Lorenzo Bellina. And from the Democratic Republic of Congo, Thierry Bolico and Steffi Impoy. Chalice that the Holy Father is using, and the ciborium, which holds the hosts, are gifts to the Holy See from the sanctuary of Caravaggio in northern Italy in the Diocese of Bergamo, which was the home diocese of Pope John the 23rd. Holy Father is now incensing the gifts. It is here that there used to be recited the prayer, "Let my prayer ascend as incense in your sight." In this biggest church in the world, there are today more than 11,000 people gathered. 30,000 had asked for tickets for this event, but only 11,000 were able to obtain them. There are the members of the diplomatic corps, including the ambassador from the United States, Francis Rooney, and his wife, and three children. The Holy Father has prayed, "Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father."
Grata tibis, Domine, quesumus. Odierne festivitatis oblatio, ut per hec sacro sancta commercia.
Lord, accept our gifts on this joyful feast of our salvation. By our communion with God made man, may we become more like him who joins our lives to yours, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord.
Gratias agamus. Domino Dio nostro.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Vere dignum et justum est, ecum et salutare, nos tibi sempre dubique gratias acere, Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterne Deus, quia per incarnati
Father all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. In the wonder of the Incarnation, your eternal Word has brought to the eyes of faith a new and radiant vision of your glory. In him we see our God made visible, and so we are caught up in love of the God we cannot see. And so, with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Cumque omni militia celestis exercitus, hymnum gloriae tue canimus, sine fine dicentes.
Oh.
The choir and the people are singing, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Igitur clementissime Pater, per Iesum Christum filium tuum Dominum nostrum, supplices rogamus ac petimus.
We come to you, Father, with praise and thanksgiving. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, through him, we ask you to accept and bless these gifts we offer you in sacrifice. We offer them for your holy Catholic Church. Watch over it, Lord, and guide it. Grant it peace and unity throughout the world. We offer them for me, your unworthy servant, and for all who hold and teach the Catholic faith that comes to us from the apostles. Cardinal Sodano reads, Remember, Lord, your people, especially those for whom we now pray. Remember all of us gathered here before you. You know how firmly we believe in you and dedicate ourselves to you. We offer you this sacrifice of praise for ourselves and those who are dear to us. We pray to you, our living and true God, for our well-being and redemption. Cardinal Echegaray reads, In union with the whole Church, we celebrate that night when Mary, without loss of her virginity, gave the world its Savior. We honor Mary, the ever-Virgin Mother of Jesus Christ, our Lord and God. We honor Joseph, her husband, the apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude. We honor Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all the saints. May their merits and prayers gain us your constant help and protection. Father, accept this offering from your whole family and grant us your peace in this life. Save us from final damnation and count us among those you have chosen. Bless and approve our offering Make it acceptable to you, an offering in spirit and in truth. Let it become for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. The day before he suffered, he took bread in his sacred hands, and looking up to heaven, to you, his Almighty Father, he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you."
Hoc est enim corpus meum, quod pro vobis traditur.
When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven."
Hic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur in remissionem peccatorum, hoc facite in meam commemorationem. Mysterium fidei.
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Savior of the world, save us. Through your cross and resurrection, you have delivered us. Father, we celebrate the memory of Christ, your Son. We, your people and your ministers, recall his passion, his resurrection from the dead, his ascension into glory. And from the many gifts you've given us, we offer to you, God of glory and majesty, this holy and perfect sacrifice, the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation. Look with favor on these offerings and accept them as once you accepted the gifts of your servant Abel, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the bread and wine offered by your priest Melchizedek. Almighty God, we pray that your angel may take this sacrifice to your altar in heaven. Then, as we receive from this altar the sacred body and blood of Christ, of your Son, let us be filled with every grace and blessing. Cardinal Lopez Trujillo prays, "Remember, Lord, those who have died and have gone before us marked with a sign of faith, especially those for whom we now pray. May these and all who sleep in Christ find in your presence light, happiness, and peace." Cardinal Ray prays, "For ourselves, too, we ask some share in the fellowship of your apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all the saints. Though we are sinners, we trust in your mercy and love. Do not consider what we truly deserve, but grant us your forgiveness.
Omnia Domine semper bona creas, sanctificas, vivificas, benedicis et prestas nobis.
Through Christ our Lord, you give us all these gifts. You fill them with life and goodness. You bless them and make them holy.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
The Holy Father, with the Cardinal Concelebrants, has sung through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. The Holy Father used tonight the first Eucharistic prayer, the traditional prayer of the, what is called the Roman Canon.
Precepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audimus dicere.
The Holy Father has now invited us to pray in the words our Savior gave us, the Our Father. Let us pray at home these words.
Quesumus Domine ab omnibus malis, da propitius pacem in diebus nostris, ut opi misericordia.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Salvatoris nostri, Jesu Christi.
The people respond, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. The Holy Father now prays, Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. The deacon sings, let us offer each other a sign of peace. And the Holy Father gives the sign of peace to the Cardinal Concelebrants and to the deacons, and the cardinals exchange the sign of peace among one another, as do the diplomats. A beautiful sign for diplomats representing many nations to express to one another the peace brought by Jesus Christ. Among the ambassadors I recognized here tonight were the Ambassador of Germany, Ambassador Westickenberg, the Ambassador of Austria, Ambassador Türk. It was his country that sent the Christmas tree. It was the country of Ambassador Westickenberg that provided the figures for the crib scene inside St. Peter's. You see the approximately 100 priests who were assisting with communion walking throughout the church to be ready to distribute communion to those who wish it. As the choir is singing, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Tollit peccata mundi, beati quia cunam anivocati son. Domine, monsum dilius, ut intre subtectum meum, se tantum di quervo, et sanabitua anima mea.
The Pope has prayed, this is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. And he, together with the people, pray, Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. He then prays quietly, may the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life, and may the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. There is Archbishop Leveda, the new head of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, putting the host in his mouth is Archbishop Michael Fitzgerald, in charge of the Council for Interreligious Dialogue. Archbishop Michael Miller of the Congregation for Catholic Education. Among the priests distributing communion this evening are a number from the Graduate House of the North American College, the Casa Santa Maria. Fathers Osmar Aguirre of Yakima, Washington, Andrew Cousins of St. Paul in Minneapolis, Stephen Doktorchik of Orange, California, Frank Chufre of the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, Paul Rezo of Steubenville, Jared Kodletz of Fargo, Gerardo Menchaca of San Jose, California, Father He Nguyen of Vietnamese background, who is a member of the Society of Saint-Sulpice, Fathers David Olson of La Crosse, Tad Oxley of Toledo, Charles Rowe of Kansas City, Missouri, Brian Sanderfoot of the Archdiocese of Washington, Gary Thomas of the Diocese of San Jose, California, and Thomas Urban of the Archdiocese of Detroit. From the Seminary Department, the North American College, there are Monsignor Daniel Muggenberg of Tulsa, Oklahoma, William Callahan, a conventual Franciscan, Mark Steffi of New Ulm, Richard Tomasek, a Jesuit, Jason Tyler of Little Rock, Arkansas, and Michael Vukey of Portland, Oregon, and several deacons, James Lease of the Diocese of Harrisburg, Deacon Jeremy Leatherby of Sacramento, and Deacon Mark Lenneman of Helena, Montana. Also, a limited number of people are able to receive communion from the Pope himself. They would write to Archbishop Piero Marini, the diocesan or the papal master of ceremonies, and ask that they might be able to receive communion from the Pope. And he would choose some on the basis of certain events, such as anniversaries or perhaps a once-in-a-lifetime visit to Rome, as is the case with the parents and grandmother of Ryan Moravitz, a student at the North American College. His grandmother, Virginia Hendrickson, and his parents, Richard and Diana Moravitz, are receiving Holy Communion from the Pope this evening. There in St. Peter's Square, you see the very beautifully illuminated Christmas tree from Upper Austria, and the crib scene. The crib scene had its origins with St. Vincent Pallotti in the church of St. Andrew della Valle, Sant'Andrea della Valle, in the heart of the historic center of Rome. It's said to be the second largest church in the center of Rome, and it is the scene for the first act of the opera Tosca. But Vincent Pallotti put 9 larger than life-size figures in a nativity scene in the 1840s, and they have since been brought to St. Peter's Square at the request of the late Pope John Paul II, who in 1982 started the tradition of putting a crib scene in St. Peter's Square. There were 9 original figures, and an additional 8 have been added. There are now 17 figures and a rather extensive crib scene. You heard the Holy Father mention the Austrians and the idea of light. A young Austrian by the name of Jürgen Lingauer, he's 11 years old, he saved his 2-year-old brother who had fallen into a swimming pool, and he was chosen by the Austrian television company to go to Bethlehem to take the light from, which is perpetually burning there at the scene of the birth of Jesus, bring that to Rome. And the light was presented to the Pope, and it has been taken around to other areas of the world to major religious leaders as a symbol of the light of Christ and the desire for peace to come from this light of Christ in the world. So the visit of the Austrians was quite significant. The 100-foot Christmas tree and this bringing of the candle. In some areas of the world, it's taken by Austrian Boy Scouts. But before Pope John Paul II, there was no crib scene in St. Peter's Square, no Christmas tree, and not even a crib scene inside St. Peter's Basilica, which is considered very unusual now, after a tradition of 23 years. As I mentioned, the cardinals were invited to come celebrate with the Pope. Of course, it was the cardinals who elected Cardinal Ratzinger as Pope Benedict XVI on April 19th of this year, not too many days after the death of Pope John Paul II. The 4 cardinals who recited the parts of the Eucharistic prayer with Pope Benedict were members of the Order of Cardinal Bishops. Historically, the cardinals had been the clergy of Rome and the bishops of the nearest dioceses to Rome. So the cardinal bishops are the titular bishops of these surrounding dioceses, and they would be the highest ranking cardinals. They would include the Cardinal Secretary of State, Cardinal Sodano, the retired president of the Pontifical Council for Justice and Peace, Cardinal Echegaray, a Frenchman who had been the Archbishop of Marseille and had been the president of the European Conference of Bishops. And then you had Cardinals Lopez Trujillo and Cardinal Rey. Cardinal Lopez Trujillo, a Colombian, the president of the Pontifical Council for the Family, and Cardinal Rey of the Conference of the Congregation for Bishops.
Danubis quesumus Domine Deus Noster, ut qui nativitatem redemptoris nostri frequentare gaudimus, dignis conversationibus, ad eius meriamur pervenire consortium, qui vivit et regnat in saecula saeculorum.
The Pope has prayed, God our Father, we rejoice in the birth of our Savior. May we share his life completely by living as he has taught.
Dominus vobiscum.
The Lord be with you.
Deus, qui gloriosa Christi filii sui nativitate,
when he came to us as a man, the Son of God scattered the darkness of this world and filled this holy night with his glory. May the God of infinite goodness scatter the darkness of sin and brighten your hearts with holiness. Amen. When the Word became man, earth was joined to heaven. May he give you his peace and goodwill and fellowship with all the heavenly host.
Deus, qui Christi nativitatis gaudium, pastoribus ab angelis voluit nunciari.
God sent his angels to shepherds to herald the great joy of our Savior's birth. May he fill you with joy and make you heralds of his gospel.
Et benedictio Dei omnipotentis, Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti, descendat super vos et mania semper.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. There will be the concluding recessional as the Holy Father carries the image, or one of the deacons carries the image of the baby Jesus to the crib scene on one of the side altars of St. Peter's Basilica. This crib scene was carved by a single wood carver in Oberammergau in Bavaria. And he began doing this in 1984 for the Holy Father Pope John Paul II and has added figures ever since. This telecast has gone to 75 nations around the world and 122 networks. In many parts of the world, it's made possible by the Knights of Columbus, a Catholic fraternal organization of men which exists in the United States, Canada, Mexico, and the Philippines.